वेलकम बैक लर्नर्स, दिस इज पार्ट थर्ड ऑन वीडियो सीरीज ऑफ पीरियडिक क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एलिमेंट्स। वी आर स्टडिंग द अर्लियर अटेम्प्ट्स एट क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एलिमेंट्स। सो फार वी हैव डिस्कस्ड डोबोनियर्स ट्राइड देन न्यूलैंड्स लॉ ऑफ ऑक्टेव। दिस इज टाइम टू डिस्कस मेंडलीव्स पीरियडिक टेबल। सो लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड इट। मेंडलीव, अ रशियन केमिस्ट, वॉज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट कंट्रीब्यूटर ऑफ द अर्ली डिवेलपमेंट ऑफ पीरियडिक टेबल ऑफ एलिमेंट्स। Okay, wherein the elements were arranged on the basis of their fundamental property, the atomic mass, and also similarity of chemical properties. Students, only 63 elements were known at that time when Mendeleev was classifying these elements. Let's understand the various criteria. First of all, on your screen, this is Mendeleev's periodic table. So we are going to study now what were the criteria selected by Mendeleev to classify these elements. Students, he examined the relationship between atomic mass of elements and their physical and chemical properties. So this was the first criteria. Later on, among chemical properties, he concentrated on the compounds formed by elements with oxygen and hydrogen, as they were very reactive and they form compound with almost all elements. He took the formula of hydrides and oxides formed by an element as one of the basic property of an element for its classification. Here on the top you can see a name written as oxide. Let me show you here, oxide. So these group, you can see R2O, this is the type of oxide formed by these members here. Then RO, the type of oxide formed by these group members. So in this manner, oxides and hydrides, the compound formed with oxygen and hydrogen respectively, they were selected as a criteria. After that, he arranged 63 elements in increasing order of their atomic masses and found that there was a periodic reoccurrence of element with similar physical and chemical properties. He observed that element with similar properties fall in same vertical column, and these vertical column are called groups. Okay, these are the vertical columns which I'm talking about. Now the horizontal rows of these elements, they were called periods. On this basis, Mendeleev gave a periodic law which is very important, you should mark it. It's the properties of elements are periodic function of their atomic masses. So this was Mendeleev's periodic law. Now students, let's talk about some important features of Mendeleev's periodic table. You can see it clearly. In this table, there were 8 vertical columns called group and 6 horizontal rows called period. Okay. In this table, Mendeleev left some gap for the elements which were not discovered at that time. He named such element by prefixing Sanskrit numeral eka, which means one, divi, two, tri, three, okay, three, in this manner. So let us discuss some of them. Here, after boron, he left a place called eka boron, and after aluminium, eka aluminium, and after silicon, eka silicon. Later on, when these elements were discovered, they were named as scandium. I'm showing you boron as well as scandium. Okay, this is aluminium, and you can see gallium, which was named eka aluminium. And I told you the third one, eka silicon. So have a look on silicon, and eka silicon was germanium, which was discovered later. Okay, not only this student, he also predicted the atomic mass and properties of several elements which were not known at that time. This was a very, very big achievement of Mendeleev's periodic table. Okay, elements like scandium, gallium, germanium have properties similar to those predicted by Mendeleev. So the properties of eka aluminium predicted by Mendeleev, they were almost same. Okay, so this was a very huge achievement. Now, in order to group elements having similar properties, At some time, Mendeleev has used. Look, Mendeleev have arranged the element into increasing order of atomic mass, but at some places he violated the law and he placed those which were having atomic mass larger earlier and which were having smaller value of atomic mass later. So here you can see the table, and let me give you some example where you can see it. Have a look on aluminium and silicon. Okay, the order of arrangement was increasing atomic mass, but here you can see this order has been not followed. So Mendeleev thought that atomic mass is not that appropriate way to consider for classification. He gave importance to the formula of oxide and hydride, and he was of the view that there can be some mistakes in calculating atomic masses. So he did not give that much priority to atomic mass. Now students, let's discuss achievement of Mendeleev's periodic table, which I have discussed earlier as well. First of all, Mendeleev left some gap into its periodic table, which we have discussed in detail. Later on, these elements were discovered, and when they were discovered, they were having most of the properties as told by Mendeleev. Now, you can see the second point, position to noble gases. Let me explain what's that. Noble gases like helium, neon, argon, they were discovered very late because they are very inert and present in very low concentration in our atmosphere. So, this is one of the strength of Mendeleev's periodic table, that when these noble gases were discovered, they could be placed in new group without disturbing the existing periodic table. So that's why I have mentioned it in achievement of Mendeleev's periodic table. Okay, so many good things with this table, but there were some limitations too. Now we will discuss some of them. First of all, its position of hydrogen. So students, let's go back and have a look on hydrogen. You will better understand it. We are once again at Mendeleev's periodic table, and here it's the element hydrogen which we are talking about. The electronic configuration of hydrogen resembles with alkali metals like lithium, sodium, potassium. Moreover, it combines with halogen, oxygen, and sulfur to give similar type of compound as given by alkali metals. These first group element which you are seeing, I have told you, lithium, sodium, potassium, they are the alkali metals. Okay, so just like NaCl, hydrogen forms HCl. Just like Na2O, hydrogen forms H2O. Okay, so these are some similarity. But just like halogen, halogens are the elements like fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, these are called halogens. So just like them, hydrogen can accept one electron and form compounds like them. So hydrogen is a non-metal and it shows many similar properties to the halogens. Okay, that's why the position of hydrogen in Mendeleev's periodic table was a bit confusing. It was showing similar properties with both halogens as well as alkali metals. So its position is a limitation for Mendeleev's periodic table. Now let's discuss the second limitation, that is position of isotopes. Students, you all know that isotopes of an element have similar chemical properties but different atomic masses. So in Mendeleev periodic table, there was no place given to these elements. Let me tell you, chlorine is having two isotopes, chlorine with mass 35 and with mass 37. Okay, but atomic number is same. The placing of these two isotopes of chlorine in the same group could not be done and could not be explained by Mendeleev's periodic table. Okay, that's why it's under the limitation. Now, uncertainty in atomic masses. You all know that another problem was atomic mass do not increase in a regular manner in going from one element to the next. If you are confused, let's go back to the table. Again, here you can see the mass of hydrogen is 1. Then come to lithium, it's 6. beryllium 9, then boron 10, carbon 12. There is no fixed number, there is uncertainty. That's why it was not possible to predict how many elements could be discovered between two elements, especially when we consider the heavier elements. Okay, now three limitation has been discussed by us. Let me tell you one more, that is placing of heavier elements before lighter one. Again, let's go back to the periodic table given by Mendeleev. Here, students, many times, as I told you about aluminium and silicon, okay, similarly, few elements, those who were having higher atomic mass, were placed before elements having a lower atomic mass. Examples are argon was placed before potassium, cobalt was placed before nickel, and tellurium. So in this manner, tellurium was placed before iodine. You can find it out. Here is your tellurium and iodine. These were the limitations, achievements, and the criteria used by Mendeleev to classify the table. Students, Mendeleev is considered a great contributor for the modern periodic law, just because he has selected these chemical properties and physical properties along with mass as a criteria for classifying elements. So that's all for today. Keep learning, keep asking.